Okay, my camera just shut off because my phone got too hot. So where were we? Oh yeah, it was about the candy. What's your favorite candy? Yeah, the ones that I was talking about. I think they are called something with farro. It's like little round balls, white balls with coconut around them, and then there is some kind of, is it called ganache inside of them, and then an almond, and oh yoy, they are simply just to die for. They are so good, but it's a very, very long time ago I had those because I don't buy them that often because I know if I buy a pack of those, I will simply just go berserk and I will just like be and gone. They are simply so delicious. But otherwise, I'm not that big of a candy eater at all. So, but yeah. Faro Rosé, I think that's the name of them. Yeah? Faro, something Rosé. But they are definitely good. Definitely good. Totally yummy. So yeah, the next question, number 20, what's your favorite sports team? Well, to be honest, I don't have any favorite sport teams at all. I never liked to watch sport, and to be honest, for me, I just, nah. I think it's boring to sit and look at. It don't excite me at all. But oops, sorry, just a little hiccup. I don't know if we had like the American football and baseball over here, it would be different. I don't know. I just don't. Nah. I really don't like to sit and spend my time watching it. I don't. And also, something I really don't understand is how people can sit and look at Tour de France and just sit and look at a bunch of men sitting on a bicycle. I never understood that if people really could sit. I don't understand why people can sit and watch that either. Or even Formula One where they are driving. I don't know. That definitely don't excite me at all. Nope, not at all. I think I will take a few more questions and then stop for today. So also this video don't get too long, and also so you guys don't get too bored. So let's go up to question number 25, and then I will stop for today. My favorite month. Well, I actually did have a favorite month, but I'm trying my best to get that one back again. But before, my favorite month was always December. I loved to find all my Santas and decorate for Christmas, but after I lost my mom the 6th December, December have not been the same for me. And for many years I haven't had any Christmas decoration up at all. So, but last year I actually did find a little bit, but yeah, not much at all. But that is something I'm working on also, is to try and get the joy back for Christmas. But yeah, because that was definitely my favorite month. Otherwise, I can't say that I have any of the other months that I have in favor. No. This one is a little bit better. I think I have to switch my tack it soon in my pens. Question number 22. What would the name of your boat be? Well, if I had a boat and you probably already guessed it what I would call it. Yep, orchid. I would simply call it orchid. Also because I love orchids so much, and so did my mom. So, if I had a boat, I would definitely call it Orchid. Or even maybe my mom's name, Sonia. So, yeah. One of those two names. Best purchase ever made. The best purchase I ever made. Oh. It must definitely be my little girl. She is my best purchase because I love her to pieces. Also, all my animals, they are the best in my life together with my boyfriend. So, yeah. So I actually think she's my best purchase at all. She definitely is. Number 24. If you had to change your name, what would it be? To be honest, I don't even want to change my name because I'm very happy about my name. Never been sad about it at all. And to be honest, I can't think about another name at all. So yeah, no name changed for me. Question number 25. If you had to lose a body part, what would it be and why? Oh, then it definitely had to be a leg, because you can still get around, even you lose a leg. But if it was your arms, then there would be no diamond painting. So yeah, definitely a leg. I think I will just keep on with the questions till I'm done. There are not that many left. 26. Can you cook? Yes, I can cook, but I don't like to cook, but I can cook. For many years ago, I got boiled water over me, so it had done so. I don't like to stand with things that are hot, so I don't like it, but I can cook. So I'm very happy that my boyfriend loves to cook, so he's the chef in our household, and nothing can make me more happy about that. Twenty-seven favorite things to cook. If there is something that I like to cook, but I sadly don't have anything of in the fridge, and I think I need to talk with one of my cousins soon again. And that is actually deer. I simply just love deer so much, and that is actually something that I like to make. So yeah, I have been brought up with deer meat and rabbits and some other birds and geese and yeah, ducks. So yeah, doves. Also because I am out of a farmer family, so I have been used to that all my life. But yeah, all of my relative is gone now, so the only one that I have left is my brother. Of course, I have my cousins, but we have never had any big relationship between us at all. And also, I am the youngest of them all. All of them now is up in the 60s, and I'm only, well, up in the 60s, late 50s, and I'm just 44, so yeah, there was a big gap between us. Number 28. What is something your brain tells you to do even though you know you shouldn't do it? Hehe. Go in and buy some more diamond paintings. I'm just like, every single day, it's like you can't keep away from AliExpress. You just have to go in and check, and Oops, then you find some other paintings that you would like to do, and now I have to sneeze. So, yeah, that's... Oh, can I keep it back? I think I can. No. Yes. Oh. Sorry, guys. Oh. And I think that was that color. Number 29. Dumbest way you have been injured. Oof. That must actually be when I was working on the factory. I was in that area where all the packed salami came out in boxes, and we had robots that took the boxes from the different lanes that came running, and I was standing for that area, and then we had what are they called? It's like a big wood plate thing that you put the boxes on, and the ones that I had gotten in, they were wet. And then sadly one of them, also one of the sides, was sticking out. So I couldn't slide it on the platform on with the robot. So then I turned it around, and then I just wanted to smash it down in the ground so it could go in, that piece of wood. And what did I do? Dropped it right down on my left foot. And I can tell you, that really did hurt so much. Oh dear, that hurt. And I actually had to go out to the emergency room because I couldn't stand on my foot. And they were so afraid that I actually had broken my foot. And they actually said that I was very lucky, because where that pallet had hit me, then my foot actually should have been broken, but it didn't. Luckily me. But I had, sadly after that, I had some blood that collected on the top of my foot, and it got encapsulated, so it couldn't get away, and the doctors just kept looking at it to see if it would get smaller, but it didn't, and I couldn't have any shoes on because it was pressing down on it, and it really did hurt. So yeah, in the end I had to get it cut out. So yeah, that's my dumbest way to get hurt. Let's see, just need my next color here. Number 30, my favorite flower. Yeah, as you guys already know, it is the orchids. I simply just love them. I love them so much. I really do. And so easy to handle too. They don't need a lot of water all the time, because I am not good at watering my plants. Many of them, if I do get some normal plants, I will simply just kill them. But I don't do that with the orchids. They just so easy for me to handle. So yeah. Number 31. Where is the worst smelling place you have ever been? Oh, yeah, that's definitely also on the salami factory. Also, I was working at the evening shift there, and when we were done, we were cleaning everything up, and then, cleaning company would come and clean all the machines and everything, but all of the salami and stuff and yucky things that dropped down on the floor when we were done, we had to put out in a room with containers, and this room was outside, and there was not any cooling on this room, so that would say in the summertime, all the different meat and the salamis, they were just starting to rot, and the floor could actually be oh so disgusting too with oh, you wouldn't believe it, and then the maggots was crawling all over the place, and oh, it was a horrible room. It was just like if you had to go in there, you would just open the door and stand ready with your bag to put it in, and you were just like counting to three, and then take a deep breath and hold your breath, and then in and put it in the containers and out again because that's how bad it was actually smelling. It was horrible. We actually call it for the rat hole. So yeah. Let's see. Number 32. If you could time travel, who would you go back in time to see and talk to? I would definitely go back and talk together with my mom because my mom, she was my everything, and I really miss her a lot. So yeah, she is the one that I would talk to, definitely. Number 33. Invite five people to dinner, living or dead. Who would it be, and why? Well, then again, it would be my relative that are dead. Also, because many times I'm sitting and thinking about all those good times we had, and how good it was when I was little, and all the fun it was. So yeah, definitely my relatives. Number 34, family food tradition. Well, we actually have one, and then that is actually for the 24th December. Also, because here in Denmark we celebrate Christmas on the 24th, and what we always get is like rice pudding, where we put a ball of butter on it, and then cinnamon sugar on top, and then we put a whole almond in the pudding, and then people have to try and see who can get it, and then the one that get the almond get a a little package. Many times it's just some kind of chocolate or marzipan pick, because that's something that is a tradition here in Denmark. And then we always have, well, in our family, we always have duck. So yeah, that is what we're having for Christmas. And now the last question, and that will be the last one, and then I will go and think I will start to look on what we're going to have for dinner, because my boyfriend is not home. Let me see, 35. If you could write a letter to your 18 years old self, what advice would you give? What advice would I give myself? Actually don't know. Maybe it should be, I don't know. I actually don't know. Just be yourself. Be kind. But that I already was back then. Yeah, maybe one thing. Don't let people treat you bad. Because I did let people step on me. So, yeah, that is definitely something that I would tell as an advice. So, not to let anybody step on you. Nope. So, yeah. Wow. That was a lot of questions. I hope I haven't bored you guys with all of these questions. I must admit, I actually had fun doing that today. It's actually much more easy when you have something to sit and talk about. Also when nothing special happens in your life or something exciting have happened. Yeah. So I actually enjoyed this, and I think I will try and see if I can find some other questions to sit and answer. Also because I like you guys to know me. And, yeah, I think I will try and look for some more, but I will just end with this last drills here, and then I will stop for today. And again, guys, I want to thank you all for subscribing, and also something that have made me very happy is actually how many of you have been writing about my pens and how much you like them. And if you actually, many of you are going to try and do them, and if you get in any kind of trouble, I will gladly help as much as I can. Also, if it means that we have to sit and talk live over Messenger, I'm totally fine with that. So yeah, But again, a big thank you for all of you that are subscribing. And if you're new to my channel and you like what you see I have done and doing, then give my videos a thumb up and subscribe to my channel. But I will go for now, and again, thank you guys. A little kiss for all of you. I can't, sadly can't give you a hug, because then I would give you all a big, big hug. I love to give people hugs. That can just mean so much for a person to get a hug. So yeah, but I will go for now, and I hope that I will get my my paintings that I'm waiting for very soon, so we can do some unboxing with these two. The one of them is my custom, and the other one is one with the special crystals one with roses. I'm so excited about that one, to see that one. So, but I will stop for now, and I hope you guys will have a good day, and have some good painting hours, and I will talk to you soon again, and I hope that I will get live soon again, because I really did enjoy it. Then maybe I just have to get all my stuff upstairs, so my boyfriend don't interrupt us. But yeah, I will go for now. So, see you later, guys. Bye.